Gender ideology, the totality of ideas about sex, gender, the natures of men and women, including their sexuality, and the relations between the genders. In this clip, fans find out that Phoebe has a supposedly gay husband from Canada. She married him so that he could obtain a green card and join the American ICE escapades. She soon finds out that he is straight and wants a divorce. He had a career as an ice skater, which led him to think that he might be homosexual. He felt pressure to fit in the skater's society that he had to convince himself and others that he shared a homosexual orientation. This view of gender roles in the workplace affected the relationship Phoebe had with him.
Oh, yeah, all right. I kinda need a divorce.
Oh, okay. How come?
Actually, I'm getting married again.
What?
Oh, God, I don't know how to tell you this. I'm straight. Yeah, I know.
I don't understand. I don't understand. How can you be straight? I mean, you're so smart and funny, and you throw such great Academy Award parties.
I know. That's what I kept telling myself, but you just reach a point where you can't live a lie anymore.
So how long have you known?
Well, I guess on some level I always knew I was straight, but... I thought I was supposed to be something else. You know, I'm an ice dancer. All my friends are gay. I was just trying to fit in, you know?
And there's actually a woman?
Her name's Deborah.
Oh. Well, is she the first that you've been with?
Well, I've never told you this, but there were one or two times back in college when I get really drunk, go to a straight bar and wake up with a woman next to me. But I told myself it was the liquor, and everyone experiments in college.
Sure.
But now I know I don't have a choice about this. I was born this way.
I don't know what to say. I mean, you know, you're married to someone for 6 years and you think you know him, and then one day he says, oh, I'm not gay.
I'm still me.
So, have you told your parents?
No, but it'll be okay. They're pretty cool. My brother's straight, so...
Gender role, the cultural expectations of men and women in a particular society, including the division of labor. In this particular episode, Ross decides whether or not he should break up with his current girlfriend to go out with Rachel. When trying to make his decision, Joey and Chandler convince Ross to create a list of pros and cons about each woman. Ross lists Rachel as the only waitress while his current girlfriend has the same job as him. Ross still breaks up with his current girlfriend to start a relationship with Rachel. Rachel finds out about the list and is stunned that Ross only thinks of her as a waitress. The differences between Rachel's career and Ross's forms a rift in their friendship as well as a possible relationship.
All right, look, let's get logical about this, okay? We'll make a list. Rachel and Julie, pros and cons.
Oh. Oh.
We'll put their names in bold with different fonts, and I can use different colors for each column.
Can't we just use a pen?
No, Amish boy.
All right, let's start with the cons, because they're more fun. Rachel first.
I don't know. I mean, all right, I guess you can say she's a little spoiled sometimes.
You could say that.
Yeah. I guess, you know, sometimes she's a little ditzy, you know. And I've seen her be a little too into her looks. Oh, and like Julie and I, we have a lot in common because we're both paleontologists, right? But I mean, Rachel's just a waitress.
Waitress. Got it. You guys want to play Doom? Or we can keep doing this. What else?
I don't know.
Oh, her ankles are a little chubby.
Okay, let's do Julie. What's wrong with her?
She's not Rachel.
Code switching. moving seamlessly and appropriately between two different languages or different styles of languages. In these couple of scenes, George Lopez gets so frustrated by his wife, he code switches between Spanish and English without difficulty in order to proclaim his frustration.
Max has been acting out to get his classmates' attention, and I think that he's doing this because he's falling so far behind academically.
Falling behind academically? Está loca, no me... Ay. So maybe the blame isn't all mine.
How can you be so heartless? Doesn't anything have sentimental value to you?
Sentimental value? Está loca, sentimental value?
Witchcraft, defined as the ability to harm others by harboring malevolent thoughts about them. The practice of sorcery, conscious and intentional use of magic with the intent of causing harm or good. In this scene of Sabrina the Teenage Witch, Sabrina tries to make everyone happy, including her science teacher Mr. Poole, by implanting a thought into the mind of her teacher. Her goal is to manipulate his mind. She has good intentions, but is altering his free will state.
Okay, you know, you seem especially bitter today.
Me? I'm fine. What a mess.
It's just a bunch of papers.
Now my life. I've been a teacher 7 years and I still can't afford a new briefcase. I found this one.
I was wondering who TGK was.
Just to pay my bills, I have to work cafeteria duty, I have to supervise the science club, and on weekends I wash Principal LaRue's car.
Well, maybe you should consider doing something else.
Like what? I love teaching science. It's the only good thing in my life.
Well, you have a lot of coupons.
Thanks.
Oh, this one for 40 cents off fruit cooks has expired.
No! Who are they fooling anyway? You can no more sweeten a cookie with fruit than you can turn lead into gold. Or can you? Wait a minute. Why didn't I think of this before? Lead is PV, mercury with... Thanks for helping me pick up my stuff, Sabrina. Now get out, I'm onto something. Yes. Yes. This wood turned lead into gold. That's alchemy and it defies the laws of physics. Oh, who cares? I'm gonna be rich! Woo!
Inculturation is the process by which people learn the requirements of their surrounding culture and acquire values and behaviors appropriate or necessary in the culture. In this clip from The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Will is attending his first dinner party as a new member to the upper-class society. He's still new to his surroundings and doesn't quite fit in yet. Also, his culture has influenced his younger cousin Ashley.
Other people at this table.
Oh, you're right. Any requests?
Sweetie, would you say grace, please?
Yes, Mommy. Hey there, Lord. My name is Ashley Banks. My family and friends want to give you some thanks. So before this dinner's all swollen and chewed, thank you, God, for this stupid food.